Hey, I'm Elly from the Maxon training team, and I'm going to be showing you exactly what a Maxon Teams account can do. Firstly, what is a Teams account? In short, it allows you to convert your Maxon licenses from personal to Teams licenses, meaning you can selectively share or float these between individual users or groups while remaining in full control. The account admin can invite and remove users from the team as and when they choose, or even pull select users into a group for more control. Let's see how we can set up our Teams account. All you need to do is log into your Maxon account, then under the Teams tab, you can contact the sales team who can assist you with converting your account. You will need to own either 3 active Teams named user subscriptions. These are licenses locked to individual users that can be easily transferred between users by an admin. Or 5 Teams floating subscriptions, which can be pulled together, allowing a set group of users to activate and release these licenses themselves without the need of an admin. Just a quick note to add, only the account owner needs to convert to a Teams account. The users don't need to change anything. Once you've made your request, our sales and support team will handle the conversion process for you, but please also be aware, converting your account revokes all assigned licenses. Once your request has been approved, your account will be converted and you'll now see the Teams view, which looks like this. You should now have 3 main columns which show your licenses, groups and users. Under the licenses column, you'll find all your existing Cinema 4D, Red Giant, Redshift and Forger licenses, including other details like the number in use, available, which group and user they're assigned to and their expiration dates. This next section is where the account admin can create groups for their team. Different groups can contain a different selection of users who will be able to access the licenses that have been assigned to that specific group. This third and final section is where you can see a list of all existing users in the team, including what group they're in and other relevant information. Now let's take a look at how you can invite a user to your team. If you go up to the top of the users column and click the Add User button, you'll be able to add your new user's details. Quick tip, if you've already set up a group, you can actually select that group when adding the user, meaning when they accept, they'll automatically be added to that specific one. You can also see all of your invited users here. These will show as pending until they've accepted. Invites that aren't accepted after a period of time will expire, but these can be deleted and resent. You can even add multiple users at once, just enter a comma after each email. Don't worry if your user doesn't have a Maxon account, they can create one when they accept the invitation. Though, please make sure they use the same email that was invited, as users cannot accept invites from different accounts. Once they've accepted, they'll be a member of the team and you can now assign them licenses. Now our user is part of the team, we need to assign them licenses. If you have named user licenses, these can only be assigned to individual users but not groups. And all you need to do is drag and drop the license onto the user or the user onto the license. You'll know this has worked as the icon will turn green. Now let's see how we can create a group for our team. If you go to the top of the groups column, you'll see a plus folder. Press this and name your group. An important thing to know is only floating licenses labeled floating or volume can be assigned to a group. If you are unsure of your license type, ask your account manager or a sales rep. Once you've got your group set up, you can easily add a user to it by dragging and dropping them on that group. Again, the target will turn green so you know it's worked. You can also easily remove a user from a group too. Just select the group from the groups column, then the all users section will change to only show the users within that group, or simply find the person you wish to remove from the all users column. Then just select the cross next to the group name and they'll be removed from that specific one. If you have Teams floating licenses, these can be assigned to the groups you have now set up. Again, just drag and drop to the appropriate column. You can easily remove a license from a user. Just find the user in the licenses column and select the cross next to their email. As the account admin, you have a lot more control over your licenses when you have a Teams account. You can view the license activity of a user by clicking the drop-down menu next to their name and selecting Show License Usage. This will show any licenses the user currently holds, and as the account admin, you can choose to withdraw the license in use if you need to. The administrator is able to control the number of licenses any one user can take, as well as the refresh time of the licenses within a group. If there are 10 licenses in a group, all of these can be taken by one user. This may or may not be desirable. In this case, an admin can limit the number of licenses any single user can take. The limit is applied to each license type in the group. You can also reduce the refresh time out here. The default refresh time of a license is set to 14 days, and this is the maximum time a user can go offline before the license needs to be reconfirmed. Sometimes an admin may wish to make this time shorter to accommodate a user leaving a device inactive or forgetting to release a license for others to use. This timeout will not remove the license from the user. They will just need to reconnect to allow continued use. Finally, you can also remove or edit a user from your team by locating them in the users column and then selecting the drop-down menu besides their name and choosing the relevant option. From here, you can view their license usage, make them an admin of the team or remove these privileges, and remove them completely. Now let's take a look as if we're a brand new user that's just been invited to a team. Once the account administrator has sent the invitation, your users will receive an email, and from here they can press view your invitations or copy the link into a browser. If the user doesn't have a Maxon account, they'll be asked to create one. If they do, they'll just need to log in. Once done, they'll see the details of the invitation, which will need to be accepted. Once this is done and your user is logged in, they can check what teams they're a member of by looking at the bottom of the licenses tab under the account identifier. They'll see the names of any groups they're a part of. For this user to now access and use licenses from the team, the account admin will need to assign licenses to the user using the instructions mentioned previously in this video. Once a user has been assigned licenses, they can now install the various software packages. All Maxon desktop applications can now be installed directly via our new Maxon app, which you can download from the Maxon website here. For more information on the Maxon app, head over to the Maxon YouTube channel and watch this video. If you have any questions regarding Maxon Teams accounts, please contact your local Maxon team or your account manager directly. Thanks for watching and enjoy your Maxon Teams account.